As we've seen, for the reckless road users out there, when an incident occurs, it rarely ends well. But last summer in the UK, it was one dangerous driver's lucky day.
It was about 6:45 in the morning, so it was fairly early. I was going to the Uxbridge boot sale. We often go down there. I was with my wife, Kay. Just poodling along, really, you know. And then out of nowhere, absolutely out of nowhere, this car came past us, sort of drifting, heading towards the bridge.
I was just shocked to see this car just come round straight in front of us. I didn't know whether we were going to hit it, it was going to hit us, and then smashed into the crash barriers, just missed the bridge.
One of the rear wheels actually flew off. Luckily, it landed right on the central reservation, and that had a bit of suspension attached to it. At that stage, I pulled straight in. Stunned, I think, at the time. We did, you know, you are stunned. The things are like that, they happen in a second. You're not ready for it, definitely not ready for it, but you've got to deal with it. You know, it might be something you don't want to see, might be something you don't want to do, but you get on and deal with it.
Finding himself first on the scene at this shocking crash, it was down to Mark to check if the driver had survived.
I managed to get one of the back doors open. I could see a hand and an arm trying to push the door open from the inside. Once we got the door open, this young lad, quite a big lad, actually crawled out.
You feel a little bit sick, I suppose, inside, because it's... You think, God, that could have been my son. No, when I saw the guy, I thought, gosh, that could have been my son. I thought,
He was holding his chest, but he was talking okay. He was able to tell us. He didn't know he'd been in an accident, because I was telling him how lucky he was. He was in denial that he was even in a car, I think, and that makes me wonder whether he'd fallen asleep. Some of the luckiest things was that he missed the bridge. Had he been a couple of seconds more, I think that would have been him gone, because if you hit that bridge, it's a sudden stop that kills you, and concrete don't move. A lot of luck, I think, yeah. A lot of luck. We didn't want to stay on a motorway. I know how dangerous they can be. And we still had some bargains to get down at the boot sale. So I said to the ambulance staff, I said, are you okay? Or, you know, can we go? And he said, yeah, we don't need you.
The crash may have lasted only 5 seconds, but it will stay with Mark and Kay for a lot longer.
When something like that happens, it does sort of imprint in your mind. It does, yeah. It teaches you to look a long way ahead as well. As soon as you see brake lights, that's a hazard. You know, you might not be close to them, but it's a hazard. Prepare, get ready.
Clearly, there are some drivers out there who think they're above the rules of the road, but deadly drivers aren't just putting themselves at risk.
I've gone to pick my wife and daughter up from an Ollie Murs concert in Liverpool. I first noticed the car just came out of a side road in front of us with no lights on.
Don't worry, the lights on.
Wait, don't worry, love. Let him get done.
It starts veering around the place. My first thought is this guy's either drunk or he's on drugs.
Completely off the side of the road, then.
At that point, obviously, I'm starting to get worried about the situation. It was swerving quite a lot.
Please,
be careful.
So obviously start describing what's going on and getting somebody to come and stop this guy as soon as possible. I don't know if he was trying to pull away from me, but it felt that way, and I was obviously then putting effort in to keep up with him.
No. He's definitely must know I'm following him now, because he's pulling away.
There was probably times where, just to keep up with this driver, I was doing 45, 50 miles an hour on a normal road.
He just nearly hit somebody.
So there was a couple of points where it does get near to other cars.
It's crashed, it's upside down.
I've never experienced anything like this before. The crash just happened suddenly and unexpectedly. Obviously, his drunken state, as it turned out, caused him to veer left into a parked car, and that was it. The car just immediately flipped over. As the crash happened, immediately we both jumped out of the car. The driver did appear injured, albeit minimally. A couple of cuts to his face. Shockingly, though, there was child seat in the car. So we were concerned at first, but then when looking again, there was nobody else but himself in there. It's made me more aware when I see a vehicle that's got no lights on there. It's just a what if. What if that happens again? What if it's more busy? People they might come into contact with.
The case with the drink driver at Wigan that was caught on dash cam, that driver was a 19-year-old male. He went to court and he was dealt with by getting a 26-month disqualification from driving. At least he's off the road for quite a while.